Please like, share and subscribe. Press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone. You are all welcome to lecture number 524. And this lecture is part second. I am going to discuss the paper, research paper, which is published day before yesterday. Is in International Journal Abstracted and it is peer reviewed journal. And I have given here the website also www.biologicalweapons.news. So here I was discussing. So this one is just like what this virus is. Engineered just like a smoking gun, and evidence that COVID-19 Wuhan coronavirus is strictly engineered as an offensive biological warfare weapon designed to target to exterminate human beings. A new research study published in the peer-reviewed journal, and the name of journal is Antiviral Research. Again, I am quoting. The name of the journal is, it is very reputed journal, and to my understanding, all the authors, I have gone through their names, mostly they are British, they are Canadian, and maybe some Americans, because Canadian-American, they work together. So, this journal name is Antiviral Research. The volume 16. For this journal, the volume is 16, and it is published in April 2020, just last week. And the spike glycoprotein of the new coronavirus, they have given this there, the spike glycoprotein of the new coronavirus 2019 and COV contains furin-like cleavage site absent in SARS and MERS. This is their reading. Very simple that this coronavirus, what we are getting, it has been engineered and made very efficient because of furin linkage site is created, which is absent in all those viruses which are already existent. And because of this, this virus is specifically designed in such a way that it will go and combine, will be absorbed very easily, because furin linkage protein, I can say, is already found in our throat in good quantity. So the absorption of this virus with this furin cleavage and our throat furin cleavage is just like lock and key. So it will be very efficient to, infect, and humans will be killed. And even if you remember, it is directly attacking to their nerve also. So once your brain is dead, even whatever is there, you are dead. So lot of, still pharmacological and toxic studies going on. So here I am giving this some extract from the research paper write-up in a simple language. In a research paper, it reveals that the COVID-19 coronavirus contains unique features that allow it to function as a more efficient weapon system for human-to-human transmission, which helps to explain why the coronavirus-19 has been impossible to contain even under quarantine. The word quarantine actually is a Latin word, but is originated from Arab, and one Persian, we can say philosopher, and scientists of 1000 AD, just like today's Einstein. Actually, he gave this concept to fight the virus, socially isolate, and he mentioned in Arabic that is quarantine. Quarantine means it is 40, means 40. And then Italian visitors, they got this information and they carried out. And then they changed into quarantine. Quarantine means in Latin or Italian language means 40. And from there it became quarantine. Quarantine means actually it is 40 days social distancing. So that quarantine condition, which have universally failed in China, Japan, South Korea, etc. Actually in China, is what problem, what they have, it is linked. Intentionally they have not done this biological weapon, but they are involved. Another is, thinking is that, because China is also having this problem of, maybe I don't know if it is human failure, whether they want to believe in depopulation or to reduce drastically the population. Otherwise, I believe that maybe by error or by mistake in the research lab of Wuhan, the scientist might have committed mistake and where in part billion, that is one part in 1 million, or part per billion, one part in 1 billion, might have been escaped, and that is enough to multiply. This also is possible in this case. That fail in the China, Japan, South Korea, etc. The research paper explains in the full text. I am not going to discuss here full text or research paper, but what a main thing is there that I am explaining here. That text, full text explains that the furin-like cleavage site is, which is missing in other virus, which is injected in coronavirus 19, cleavage site may provide a gate to function to 2019 coronavirus efficiently. So this site, which is injected or engineered in coronavirus 19, that is called COVID-19 disease, to make it very efficient, very fast, and to work especially in throat, because the spike protein, and that is called furin cleavage site, there is lot of, I mean, in good quantity, in large quantity, it is found in our throat, respiratory trachea is there, and that's why it is matching with that. A cleavage site and may provide again to function to 2019 COVID efficient spreading in the human population. The research paper finds that there is no known viral protein ancestry to the COVID-19, and they have done the research and they found that in ancestorial viral, such type of furin cleavage site is not available. So here, after going through the paper, this research paper, I have given the in summary of that text, that the researchers, they have got the full information. It is genetic material information, genome information, sequencing information. They found that SARS and MERS, which are naturally existing, they are having similarities. But the virus, that is coronavirus 19, in that there is a furin cleavage site, and that is making it efficient. This is the summary. So here it is. The summary: in 2019, a new virus, 2019 NCO, infecting humans, has emerged in Wuhan, China. Its genome has been sequenced, and genomic information promptly released despite the high similarities with the genome sequence of SARS and MERS like viruses, there is identification of peculiar furin like cleavage site in the spike protein in the 2019 CO lacking in SARS and MERS. In this research paper, authors discuss the possible functional sequences of this cleavage site. So let me explain in Hindi, Indian language. भाई ऐसा है कि अब तक का अभी जो आज मैंने डिस्कस किया वेरी क्लियर इसमें हो गया, रिसर्च पेपर आया, सब लोगों ने उसका सत्या पाचा किया। भाई इसमें जो चाइना में जहाँ रिसर्च सेंटर है वहीं कोई गड़बड़ी की है और इसके अंदर स्पीड बढ़ाने का सितावा लगाया गया है इस वायरस के अंदर। बकिया सब अपने चाल पे चल रहे हैं लेकिन एकदम से हवाई जहाज जो बन गया है इसके अंदर, एक को कहते हैं वो सब साइंस की बात है प्रोटीन की, उसका नाम है फ्यूरिन क्लीवेज साइट। ये जब जिसके अंदर लग जाता है तो बहुत ज़्यादा इफिशियंट हो जाता है, बहुत तेज़ी आ जाती है। अब ये एक इस टाइप का प्रोटीन हमारे गले वगैरह में बहुत पाया जाता है तो ये उसके साथ जाके बिल्कुल घाव माव मिल जाता है। तो ये एक इंसान को ख़त्म करने का ये बनाया गया है, अब एक नया तरीका निकाला है। या तो हो सकता है भाई, ये हमारा शक है, ये उन लोगों ने नहीं बताया है किसी ने, ये एज ए केमिस्ट मेरा शक है कि या तो भाई पूरी दुनिया का पॉपुलेशन ये ख़त्म करना चाहते हों, बहुत कम करना चाहते हो, डेट इज कॉल्ड डीपॉपुलेशन, वो करना चाहते हो, या कोई बहुत लंबी चाल हो, या हो सकता भाई उनसे साइंटिस्टों से थोड़ी सी गलती हो गई हो। बहरहाल इसमें कोई दो राय नहीं है कि इसको हवाई जहाज बनाने में तो इतना इन्फेक्शस, इतना आपका स्पीडी तो पूरी दुनिया में इस पार कर रहा है, इसमें इंसान का हाथ है। Let me take this opportunity to inform you that some 2-3 days before I have already mentioned about the plasma vaccine and plasma testing. Those who are research worker in this protein chemistry, in virology, in microbiology, let them listen my lecture. Those who are doing their masters or even PhD research work, because just now I got one paper where it is mentioned that the top rank medical school, John Hopkins University, where there is medical school, John Hopkins Medical School, they have given the clearance and approval to do the plasma testing and for plasma vaccine. And plasma testing, I have explained in detail, it is just to detect the antibody which is formed in our plasma. And those antibodies, protein, I am going to discuss detail in the next lecture. Actually, I was supposed to discuss that one, but in the meantime, I got this paper. So I thought, let me discuss this thing. Thank you very much once again.